on this video. Look at this. Look at this right here. This is like, you see how that's like sticking up? This is the end of my hair. It's a lot longer, mind you. But forget that. I messed it up. I left it there. Look, you see how it sticks up right there? I mean, that's ridiculous. Look at this. Look at that. It's sticking up. Up. It's like this and then up. I'm like, honestly, it's like the hair not only wants to stick out like this, but it wants to stick up. So the hair is like this, like a ballerina. It's ridiculous. The hair is just miracle growing out of my scalp, okay? All natural hair is just miraculous hair. Like, really. How are my edges looking, okay? Look at my edges first off. The scalp oil, okay? I've been totally slacking on taking my scalp oil. I'm doing it only once a week when I do my wash days, and you don't do that. That's what you don't do. You need to do this at least 3 times a week. I made another video about this. Okay, about the scalp oil. It's just like, I'll link that video down below in the description box. I use it to grow my hair, right? The scalp oil. And I've been completely slacking, like, but it's been holding up. And I do attribute that to the fact that I still do it once a week when I do my wash days. But I also have been using my D3. But let's not get into the whole D3 because I have a whole other rant about that D3. It's like upsetting me. But yeah, I'll post that video soon. But this thing, what is this comprised of? This is just castor oil and extra virgin olive oil. I've said this like 10,000 times. I do want to add some other stuff to it. I mean, it's magic in a bottle, honestly. That's why I just don't add anything to it. But I do want to add, what is it? Rosemary oil, maybe some tingling scalp oils. And what else did I want to add to it? Just the tingles, and then I wanted to do it more. I think I wanted to try warming it once, but that's really unnecessary. Mainly just the tingling essential oils. I want to add that to it. So I will let you know how that goes and if it, you know, speeds up the whole process. And a major component to my whole edge situation and keeping it nice and thick, because it has thickened up. It's not as thick as I would like it to be, but it's really nice. It's pretty thick right now. It could be better if I was doing it 3 times a week, like I'm supposed to. But I'm only doing it the 1 time a week. Okay, but what else has attributed to my edges like keeping, like staying intact? I know I made a couple of videos about sleeping on a satin scarf, and it's so much better to sleep on a satin scarf rather than just with the stay-on satin scarf, because the stay-on, that brand, stay-on satin, rips my hair out of my head. It really does. Just traditionally, it's not healthy for my edges. But a normal, just completely silky, satiny scarf that's not, because what is it with the stay-on satin brand? That brand has a special weaving on the inside of it that rips and tugs at my edges and actually rips it out. But a normal, regular, just completely smooth, silky, or satiny, or polyester silk, fake polyester thing, is completely fine. And I found that I like this better than just a satin scarf. And if I really want to be extra fancy, I would sleep on a satin scarf and wrap my entire head, edges and all, with a satin scarf. You know, a large, like a triangular type formation with this. And that's what I've been doing. And that really helps. Of course, it doesn't look cute, but it's just really, really nice for the edges. I mean, it's complete protection for the edges when you sleep. And there's nothing that kills your edges more than a cotton pillowcase. I'm telling you, and cotton sheets. It will just like kill, kill, kill. And we don't want to do that, okay? We don't want to kill the edges. We want to keep them nice and happy, okay? That's what we like. Yes, I need to buy more because I only have like 2 of these. How many? Yes, only 2 of these that really, is it 2 or 3? I have 3, but the third one isn't as good as the first 2. I mean, the third one's a little bit short, and some of the hair in the back sticks out, and I don't like that. So yeah, I gotta get some more and cuter ones, like more fashionable. I mean, this is nice and everything, but it's like really kind of grandma-ish, I think. But yeah, if I just got some plain colored ones, like I'm thinking pink, black, white, monochromatic, but not really, because I like pastels. So maybe some pastels, some monochrome, you know, like that. So that's what I'm looking at for the whole edge situation, and getting back majorly on this to 3 times a week, because I really don't do it well. And I already told you the proper way of doing it. So I'll give you the introduction, what is it and why it's beneficial, and then how you should do it, because there's a specific way. You don't just put this on dry scalp. No, that's bad, because that's not as effective. There's a specific way to put on your growth oil that really enhances the growth process, okay? And I'm gonna link that video down below in the description box as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you in the next video. Later.